Rated M for mature.
What is it?
Out of the way, meat.
Out of the way, meat.
Oh, you've saved me. Thank you so much. Who knows what they'd have done to me if you hadn't come along. I promise I'll help you get out of here. The books? Oh, I see. I thought perhaps... Well, I thought you'd come for me. But yes, the books. The caller will have them. She was most interested in one of the volumes. Although not interested enough to keep me from being locked up. Don't you need my help? I shall do my best.
So you're the one who barged into my home and laid waste to my projects. How nice to meet you. So you're just one of Arryn's lackeys. That's disappointing. You show real promise. You come here, kill my assistants, disrupt my work. You've annoyed me, so I don't think I'll be giving you anything. Fine. Take them and be gone. Never return here, or else you'll face my full wrath.
They say knowledge is its own reward.
If you have a moment,
I still don't see why we had to bring it back here.
The Archmage believed it important. It must be powerful.
We don't
need something.
We don't even know what it is. Where is Arryn anyway?
Well, well. And you seem to be in one piece. Thank you. I'll look these over and inform Mirabelle if I find anything relevant. Night of Tears, eh? I remember this one. Well, isn't that interesting? Did you read it yourself? If I recall it correctly, that has some interesting implications. You should mention that to Toldir. And here. I suppose you've earned...
encouraging to see the younger generations embracing education. Did he now? Does he have information about our wonderful discovery? Is that the one about something buried beneath Sarfall? Something that Men and Mare fought over? I'll have to make a point of rereading it. I don't recall the details. I just can't seem to tear myself away. Whatever this is, its beauty is like nothing I've ever seen before. If you'd allow me to indulge myself for a moment, I thought I might make a few observations. I'm sure you've already noticed the markings. They're quite unlike anything we've seen before. Aeliad, Dwemer, Daedric, not even Farmer. None of them are a match. Quite sure. For I'm not sure. This marvelous object, it practically radiates magicka. And yet, it's unlike anything I've felt before. Archmage Arryn is already hard at work, and hopefully we'll have more information soon.
I'm afraid I must intrude. It is urgent that I speak with your associate immediately.
This is most inappropriate. We're involved in serious research here.
Yes, I've no doubt of its gravity. This, however, is a matter that cannot wait.
Well, quite sure I've never been interrupted like this before. The audacity. I suppose we'll continue this at some later time, when we can avoid interruptions.
I need you to come with me immediately. Let's go.
Really?
Well, allow me to clarify the situation. I'd like to know why there's someone claiming to be from the Psijic Order here in the college. More importantly, I'd like to know why he's asking for you specifically. So we're going to go have a little chat with find out exactly what it is he wants. Technically, that is true, but I still report to the Old Merry Dominion, and I cannot ignore this situation. Don't worry. You can return to your petty squabbles and meaningless research as soon as this matter is resolved. You are going to speak to this monk and find out why he is here. Now, you are going to speak to this monk and find out why he is here, and then he will be removed from you.
Please, do not be alarmed. I mean you no harm. It is good to meet you in person. I merely wish to talk to you. I've given us a chance to speak privately, but I'm afraid I can't do this for long. We must be brief. The situation here at your college is of dire importance, and attempts to contact you, as we have previously, have failed. I believe it is due to the very source of our concern. This object, the Eye of Magnus, as your people have taken to calling it. The energy coming from it has prevented us from reaching you with the visions you have already seen. The longer it remains here, the more dangerous the situation becomes. And so I have come here personally to tell you it must be dealt with. You set this chain of events in motion at Sarfall. You must understand the Psijic Order does not typically intervene directly in events. My presence here will be seen as an affront to some within the Order. As soon as we have finished, I will be leaving your college. I'm all too aware that my arrival has aroused suspicion, especially in Onkano, your Thalmor associate. Nevertheless, my Order will not act directly. You must take it upon yourself to do so. I presume you refer to Onkano's distaste for the Psijic Order. The Thalmor see our Order as a threat because we have power, and we will not allow them to control us. I assure you that we mean you no harm. As you may have learned, this object, the Eye, is immensely powerful. The world is not ready for it. If it remains here, it will be misused. Indeed, many in the Order believe it has already. Rather, something will happen soon, something that cannot be avoided. We believe that your efforts should be directed towards dealing with the aftermath, but we cannot predict what that will be. I fear I have already overstepped the bounds of my order, but I will offer this. Seek out the Augur of Dunlane, here in your college. His perception may be more coherent than ours. I am unsure. He is somewhere within the college. Surely one of your colleagues must know his location. I am sorry I cannot provide you with further help, but this conversation requires a great deal of effort on my part. Now, I'm afraid I must leave you. We will continue to watch over you and guide you as best we can. It is within you to succeed. Never forget that.
I'm sorry.
Well, what is the meaning of this?
I'm sorry, I'm afraid I don't understand.
Don't play coy. You asked to see a specific member of the college. Here she is. Now what is it that you want?
There's been a misunderstanding. Clearly, I should not be here. I shall simply take my leave.
What? What trickery is this? You're not going anywhere until I find out what you're up to.
I am not up to anything. I apologize if I have offended you in any way.
We will see about this.
I'm not sure what happened. A monk from the Sijic Order. Here after all these years, and then he just leaves. I hope we didn't offend him somehow. What you learn here will last you a lifetime. Several. Has Tofdir been telling stories again? I thought I made it quite clear that this was a subject inappropriate for conversation. Please, don't allow him to continue to discuss the subject. Beyond asking for you, he never said. Very strange indeed. Until next time.
Always encouraging to see the younger generations embracing it. Well now, there's a name I haven't heard in some time. My goodness, it's been years since I've spoken with him. I suppose he's still down in the midden, but I haven't checked. Are you going to see him? Do tell him hello for me, won't you? Underneath the college, it's not the nicest place, so if you go down there, please do be careful. Well, I suppose he wouldn't mind. It was all before my time, you understand. I've heard the stories, the same as anyone else. He was a brilliant student, an accomplished wizard, delved into magic in a way none had seen before. But I think he became too focused on just how much power he could acquire. That's what led to the accident. Do you remember what I first told you? About how not being able to control magic could destroy you? I didn't simply mean it could kill you. The Augur's accident is another very real type of a life destroyer. Well, it's been described as an accident. I can't imagine it was intentional. Something must have gone wrong, and he ended up in the state he's in now, fused to the energies that flow through the college. I've never felt it appropriate to ask him about it, about how that must feel. I suppose, if he can feel it all. All right, then.
perseverance will only lead to disappointments. Still, you persist. Very well. You may enter. I am that which you have been seeking. Your efforts are in vain. It has already begun. Those who have sent you have not told you what they seek, what you seek. You seek that which all who wield magic seek, knowledge. You shall find this. Knowledge will corrupt, it will destroy, it will consume. You seek meaning, shelter in knowledge. You will not find it. The Thalmor sought the same thing, and it shall lead to his end, as it has so many others. No, though you may be the last, the one who calls himself Ancano has sought my knowledge as well, through very different questions. Your path differs from most. You are being guided, pushed towards something. It is a good path, one untraveled by many. It is a path that can save your college. I will tell you what you need to know to follow it further. You, and those aiding you, wish to know more about the Eye of Magnus. You wish to avoid a disaster of which you are not yet aware. To see through Magnus's eye without being blinded, you require his staff. Events now spiral quickly towards the inevitable center, so you must act with haste. Take this knowledge to your Archmage.
It's no secret that the college's reputation in Sky... Really? And what might that be? I'm sorry, what? Well, I'd certainly love to have such a powerful staff, but I'm not really sure that any of us need it. And how do you know of this? Did you really? And he specifically mentioned the staff of Magnus? I'm impressed with your initiative. Of course, someone will need to follow up on this. I certainly do. Since you went so far as to seek out the Augur for advice, I thought you'd be more enthusiastic. Something as specific and ancient as the Staff of Magnus. I'm not sure we'd ever find something like that. I seem to recall Mirabel mentioning the staff somewhat recently. Why don't you see if she can tell you anything? I'm quite pleased with your progress, you know. You've certainly proven yourself to be more than a mere apprentice. Well done. This circlet once proved invaluable to me. I hope it can be of use to you now.
Please don't. If there are any problems, let me know. It's my job to keep things running smoothly. Well, now that's an odd question. Why in the world would you be asking? I see. Well, yes, I suppose I did mention it, though I'm not sure what he expects me to tell you. I only brought it to his attention a few months back when the Synod showed up here looking for it. They were apparently under the impression we were keeping it in a closet somewhere. Mages based out of Cyrodiil. They fancy themselves the imperial authority on magic these last few hundred years. My understanding is that all they really do is make noise in an attempt to curry favor from the Emperor. Lots of politics, little magic. I was quite surprised to find them on our doorstep. They seemed amiable enough, but their line of questioning made me uneasy. It became clear they're trying to hoard powerful artifacts, looking to consolidate power. No one here does. The Synod seemed convinced it was somewhere in Skyrim. They inquired about the ruins of M'Zulft, but that's all I remember. It sounded like they were heading there, though they were rather secretive about why. I suppose if you're intent on looking for the staff, there's a chance they might be in M'Zulft yet. Just don't expect them to be cooperative. I'm not really sure. Made and used by Magnus himself, if you believe those sorts of things. I believe I've heard it said that it's the only thing that could adequately contain his power. The sort of embellishment wizards of ancient times loved to make.
assault, Outlander. By the code of Malachan, this stronghold belongs to the Orcs. Your kind are unwelcome. We won't kill you, Outlander. We don't want you here. Remember that.
Crystal.
Gone.
Find Baratus. In Oculori.
Gavros! Is that you? I'd almost given up hope. Let me get the door.
What the? What are you doing here? What have you done with Gavros? It was the Falmer, wasn't it? Curse them! They've ruined everything! If Gavros is gone, there is no hope. He was supposed to return with the crystal. Without that, all our efforts are wasted. And you, if you're here for treasure or wisdom or anything, I'm afraid you've wasted your time. It didn't work the first time. I tried to tell Gavros, but he wouldn't listen. No, it won't be too cold, he said. Well, I was right, wasn't I? Folk is completely wrong by the time we got here. The cold had warped it. Gavros had to cart it all the way back to Cyrodiil. Left the rest of us here to fend off the damnable Falmer. You found... How in the world? That's it? That's it! I don't know who you are, but you may have just saved this little project. In fact, who are you anyway? You are you? Savos wouldn't even grant us an audience when we came to you. But now you come here expecting something from me? I don't much like this, I'll tell you. But you saved my skin, so maybe I can overlook the past for now. Come on, I'll explain on the way. No matter what Gavros said, this was my idea first. The Council is going to know that when I get back. I was the one who thought of using this oculory. I don't know what the dwarves called it. Something unpronounceable, I'm sure. From all our research, it seems they were intent on discerning the nature of the Divine. This machinery, all of it, was designed to collect starlight, and then, I'm not sure, split it somehow? It was my idea to replace one of the key elements with our focusing crystal. Months of enchantments went into it. Let's just hope they got it right this time. Here it is. Magnificent, isn't it? Took an incredible amount of work to get it running again. Now I'm hoping it'll all be worth it. Place the crystal in the central apparatus, and we can start the process for focusing it. finally going to pay off. But what's this? These results, they're not at all what they should be. This projection should be lit up like the night sky. Something is creating an incredible amount of interference. Something in Winterhold, it looks like. What are you playing at? Is this some attempt to stall my work? So what is it? What have you done? Did you know what we were attempting? Are you here to make sure your plan worked? That our efforts have been for nothing? Well, explain yourself. You and your college have ruined years of my work. I've lost colleagues and friends to the Falmer, and you want me to calm down? How did you do it? Just look! This should be lit up brighter than the night sky, and it's not! Clearly you've interfered somehow. Or, you have something at your college, don't you? Something immensely powerful, beyond anything I've anticipated. What is it? So you do have something, then. Whether this was intentional or not, it suggests some interesting results. Yes, the staff. Interesting. I can't explain the details. That would be many secrets the Synod have learned over the years. Also, I doubt you'd be able to comprehend the details. Have you seen the orrery in the Imperial City? It was the inspiration for this idea. Instead of projecting the sky, we project all of Tamriel, and then harness the latent energies to overlay the positions of... What's important is that all of this work was designed to reveal to us sources of great magical power. Purely to help safeguard the Empire, of course. And yet, in the end, only two locations have been revealed to us. One is your college. The other, well, that can only be Labyrinthian. So, mage from Winterhold, despite your intentions, I've beaten your little game. Even if all you've said here is lies, I know you have something in Winterhold the Synod Council will be very interested in. So fine, trudge off to Labyrinthian in search of your staff. I shall return to Cyrodiil and deliver my full report to the Council. This is not over, I assure you. Well, yes. Probably. I mean, yes. Certainly it is. But that doesn't matter now. Because I know you're hoarding something even more important at your college. The Council will be informed of this. They will find out what you're up to. Am I? Am I? I think I've discovered more here than I could have hoped to. Your trickery won't confuse me. I think we're done here. You got what you came for.